Now for My News 26, it's high school hockey, coming to you from the Wex in Cadillac.
All right, we're back for the third period action. Jeff Castillo and Bill Dooley here from the Wex in Cadillac. And Jeff, it's 3-1. Cadillac is, you know, they need something right now to kind of to break that ice, so to speak.
Yeah, they've got to come out and start bringing it a little bit heavier here, because Alpena's been all over them, out playing them, out skating them, out shooting them,
out hitting them.
Yeah, out hitting them, pretty much everything, and outscoring them so far. But it's anybody's game right now. Still.
Yeah.
I mean, 3-1 mm-hmm. is not an insurmountable lead by any stretch of the imagination. Alpena is out shooting the Cadillac Vikings right now, 26-10.
Whoa.
So that's a pretty big advantage. But Nick Myers so far has been he's been the man. He's been standing tall and keeping him in the game. So he's given his team an opportunity to win the game is what he's doing. That's what you want from your goalie. So
yeah, I saw his dad Jim and I said, "Boy, Jim, Nicky's standing on his head. He's keeping him in him," and he just shook his head like, "Wow,
he really is." And on the other end there, Dakota Meyer. You know, he's probably just maybe hoping for a little more action, because I think he might be back there yawning. I don't know.
Yeah.
He hasn't gotten a lot of action, but he's been good and solid in there when he needs to be.
When called upon, yeah.
Yep.
And the only goal was scored by who, Jeff, for Alpena in that period, the second period? Or there's two goals.
Yeah, they actually end up having two goals. Colby Plowman scored the first goal from Evan Letourneau and Nate Cosbett, and then Evan Letourneau scored that last goal with an assist from Kyle Van Dusen, making it a 3-1 game.
In their first period, their goal was scored by
Shane Hemp.
Shane Hemp.
And
that
assisted by Owen Lindback and Ben Uchik.
That's Budnik.
Budnik.
Budnik, good Polish
name. Can't read my own writing.
All right.
And Cadillac has got one power play goal by Mike Gussert from Ben Farley. So that sums up the scoring action for this evening's contest.
All right. The puck is shot into the Cadillac zone. Letourneau with a centering attempt, and the Vikings will come out with it. Ben Farley, starting off the third period, cuts back, knocks his man down, and the puck comes at the blue line. Nice keep in there by the Vikings. Flipping it high in the air to Letourneau. He's got to watch out here. He took a hit earlier in that same spot.
Yeah, he did.
But he played an awesome second period. Now the puck is kept in by Cam Cosbett. He's got some size to him too, Jeff, number 16.
Yeah, he really does. He is a senior also. Both these squads have a lot of seniors, so it's nice to see a good couple of veteran groups out there going at each other.
Behind the net, Mike Gussert for the Vikings. He'll flip it up into the air, and that'll go all the way down the ice for an icing. With 15:56 to go in the third period, the Vikings are down 3-1.
And at this time, we would like to mention that the Wexford-Missaukee ISD Digital Media Productions is providing students a hands-on experience by partnering with MyNews 26 and CCTV to learn about directing, broadcasting, and all aspects of digital production. Thanks again to the ISD and all those involved in this cooperative venture.
All right, back to the action now. We've got Brennan Phillips out there along with Brock Taylor, Justin Smith, Alex Kaspriak, and Brendan Shanahan. That was out in front of the net. A little dangerous play there. Vikings do not get it out of the zone. Alpena, it's been a reoccurring theme here tonight with their great forechecking.
They have definitely had the forecheck going on tonight.
Puck is played right back up the boards, and stepping and taking it away is Brock Taylor, and he whistled that one wide. Camp takes a hit from Kaspriak, and then coming right back the other way is Brandon Eller. Eller dumps it into the zone, but it's taken right by there by the Wildcats, tipped nicely by Nick Esch. Nick has played a really good game for Alpena. Ash tried to center it, but taking that away nicely. Good move there, and then following up is Brendan Shanahan. It's Shanahan on three, and he dumps it in the zone. They were going on a change there. That's why he only had one person there to help. Aaron Nowak for Alpena. Gerstenberger's out there, and he hasn't been out there too much tonight for Cadillac, number 17.
Right, Gerstenberger, Hayden Watkins, and Ian Munch.
Yep.
Also out there, so getting some play early in the period here.
And a lot of times coach is going to look for that spark, Jeff. I mean, a line may not get a lot of playing time, but when he wants out there, he says, guys, make something happen for me.
Get him a little experience.
Back to the point to Brian Geiger. Had trouble with the puck. Goes around his man, and then Alpena, with its persistence, will play it back in the corner. And Evan Letourneau out to center. They got a man just a little bit off his stick, but looking to center for the redirection. Back to the point. Now Letourneau will dump it in the corner. That's Colby Plowman. Kyle Van Dusen, number 21. He loses it, and coming away with it is Matt Fox. Hayden Watkins for the Vikings. Watkins on the right side. He is checked by his man. Got interference, maybe?
Yeah, they are giving him interference.
I'm surprised. I mean, the first time was okay, but then when he went at it again.
That second time not letting him through might have been the deciding factor in calling the penalty on that.
Yeah, the referees will give you a little bit of leeway, but if you do it again, they'll more than not call it.
Okay, and that is that's a third penalty tonight on Alpena, so we're going to see the Cadillac power play squad out there.
And they're going to bring their big line of Gussert and Brock Taylor, Farley, Fox, and Leotard. There's a shot. Makes it through. Good save there by Dakota and Meyer.
And they do have one power play goal to their credit tonight. That was that
quick one by Gussert. Gussert takes a hit, but there's another Wildcat picking right up after the check, Jeff. They have been very consistent with that.
Yeah, they have. They've got good puck support.
All right, the Vikings behind their own net. Alpena's just content to let them stay back there for a little bit. Here's a pass to Gussert. Gussert over the blue line. He's going to try and set it up. Got a backhanded into the zone. Cam Leotard for the Vikes. Holds on to it. Centers, good redirect there out to Farley. Back to Gussert. Gussert to Farley.
Farley's going to be looking to shoot. That was more of a pass shot there.
Fox looking out front. Good defense there by the Wildcats. Now coming back in is Cam Leotard. Blocked right there by Nathan Cosbitt on a good defensive play. Over to Ben Farley.
Play by Brock Taylor, too, over there to keep that puck in the zone.
Yeah. Holding it along the board, so the referee's going to have him move it out. It comes loose. Ben Farley cannot hold it in, and the Wildcats are going to go for a change with 30 seconds to go in the power play. Matt Fox right back over the line, going wide, holding on to it. And clearing the zone is Kyle Van Dusen for Alpena. Brock Taylor lost it. Letourneau will dump it in, then he takes a hit from Farley again. There's that same combo, Farley against Letourneau.
Been familiar with the boards on this side, that's for sure, tonight.
There's a takeaway. Yeah, good call by the referee, because that was offside. And I think that's where they work together. Jeff, you'll see that the linesman was down on the power play side, we call it, and then the back referee had to make the call, even though he was down deep.
Yeah, whatever it takes to get it right.
And that's exactly it. You're not going to hurt anybody's feelings.
Nope.
Puck is played over to David Carpenter. He overskated it. Gets it up to Alex Kasprzak. Kasprzak lets a snapper go wide of the net. Taken down there is Letourneau looking for a call. Uh-oh, that could be a call. When you kick the stick of somebody's like that.
Yeah, did the Alpena player push his stick away?
Evan Letourneau kicked the stick away from the Cadillac player. Usually that'll be an interference call, but there's an icing call against Alpena, so they kill off the power play, and there's 11:13 to go in the game. It's 3-1, the Wildcats. Jeff Castillo and Bill Dooley on a Friday night in Cadillac. And we got some more hockey coming up next week, Jeff. I'm not sure who's playing, but I know the Vikings will be here with the cameras and be covering some more hockey.
Looking forward to that, bringing more action to you. Cadillac's got a fairly young line out there right now with Alex Leotard, Derek Tonello, and Alan Shear.
There's a giveaway, one of the few by the Wildcats. Chasing in the corner is Derek Tonello. Tonello gets crunched by a couple Wildcats. He's still battling for the puck. He's got some help there from Alex Leotard. And coming away with it are the Wildcats. 2-on-1 for the Wildcats. Cosbett, beautiful diving save. That's Carpenter again, and he's made a couple of those.
Yeah, he has. He's got that feet-first blocking style. I like it.
Yeah, it's effective.
That's worked a couple times tonight.
Joe St. John, I think, is going to get one of the Wildcats for hitting from behind. Maybe he'll give him a cross-check here to, because he kind of let up. Let's see what his call is.
Talking it over here a little bit with the ref and linesman.
And you have to admit, Alpena started in, but then they let off on the hit. And you can see maybe a cross check here, but we'll see if they're going to give them a 2 and a 10. That's what they're talking about right now.
Okay. Cadillac.
Sponsors, Jeff. We get our sponsors going here.
Absolutely. We've got Pizza Plus. Some of the best pizza in town here in Cadillac. High Point Cadillac GMC, servicing your new and used car needs. And Cadillac Tire, which is probably pretty busy right now with the pending snow
right
just around the corner. At any time, make sure you got good tires for your winter driving.
All right, they're going to go with 2 minutes. I think that's a good call there. There was no injury. He let up on the hit. We're not sure if it's cross-checking or whatever they called, but we'll get it in a second. Now the Vikings go to work on the power play. Farley in the corner to Gussert. Gussert to Farley. Nice play there by Rosnowski. Rosnowski just fighting hard, getting that puck over the zone. Pass into Brock Taylor. Taylor high and wide of the net. Chasing it down is Cam Leotard. Now Matt Fox goes right back at the net. Back to Farley, to Gussert. Gussert,
nice pad save.
Yes. Meyer stuck out that right pad. You can hear it from up here. He's been impressive when he's been called on tonight.
Yeah, he has. He didn't have a lot of chance on the goal that he did give up. He's been pretty solid other than that.
Yeah, Nick Esch just picked the pocket of Ben Farley, and they'll take their time, and then all the way down the ice.
And that one was on net.
Right on net.
Yep, Nick Meyer had to make a save there.
And Nick Esch, by the good read on that, forces a faceoff.
53 seconds left in the Cadillac power play. Bringing out some fresh legs. Looks like they've got Alex Kasprzak, Hayden Watkins, and the best name in hockey, Brendan Shanahan, number 14.
Brendan Shanahan.
Brendan had a real successful cross-country endeavor this fall. Did really well. Got a few awards, I think. They had their banquet the other night, so congratulations to Brendan on his season.
A lot of these players will play. Oh, what an alert play by Nick Meyer.
Wow.
That was Shane Hamp, number 20.
Just stuck his stick out and got the deflection there. And, boy, they dodged a bullet there. Oh. That would have been a shorty.
So the faceoff will stay in the Cadillac zone. There's 42 seconds left in the power play, but so far Alpena has had the best opportunity.
And I think Nick Meyer's going to have a little conversation with his defenseman there when he gets a chance.
We talked about that on the pregame. I said, Nick, what are the things you appreciate from your defense? He goes, well, those quick passes, when they
cross
get it out of the
crease.
Zone real quick. Yeah. Wade Rosnowski backhands it and a good play, and he's playing a strong defensive game. Number 22, Wade Rusnowski.
Yeah, he really has, one of the captains on the Alpena squad.
That one is tipped away, and Alpena is kind of having their way here with this power play. They kill it off.
And we are back to even strength.
It is 3-1 with 8:17 to go in the third. Shanahan, the puck is picked up by Carpenter, and holding on to it's Dakota Meyer.
Yep, smart play by the goalie, leaving no rebound.
And I think he wanted his team to, yeah, just kind of after that kill, he wanted to get the troops back in.
Yep. Time to regroup, get who they want out on the ice. And Cadillac brings their top line. Brendan Phillips and Matt Fox on the defense.
Here's a pass to Phillips. That's wide of the net. And Owen Limbach clears, kept in nicely by Phillips. And then it's taken away by Van Dusen. Van Dusen with some speed going down the side at the backhander. And Meyer stood his ground.
Wow. A nice play by Kyle Van Dusen there to steal that puck, and he really showed some good speed there.
Yeah, really, they can throw out several lines at you and really put some speed and some talent. They're going to be a force to be reckoned with in the Big North, no doubt about it.
Yeah, absolutely. They have they've had a real strong night tonight, and I'm impressed. He's got a good squad.
Van Dusen was dipsy-doing with it. Finally comes out to center. And Ben Budnick, nice move. Ben Budnick just gets it over to the blue line, and picking up is Evan Letourneau. Van Dusen with a good pass. Keep your head up there, Colby. Matt Fox again.
You want to keep your head up with Matt Fox lurking. He can really put one on you.
Off the glove and right to Alpena, so there's no hand pass there. Making a change out of the Wildcats. Down hard goes Brock Taylor. That was Lars MacArthur with a big hit. Alpena is just, like I said, they're punishing Cadillac at every opportunity.
Yeah, and they're always a physical team. We've seen them year in and year out, and they like to play physical in your face type of hockey.
Gerstenberger takes the hit, and then coming in with it is Nathan Cosbett. He'll wind up, and that one is blocked by Fox. Now Cam Cosbett, his brother, takes a shot wide. Coming out to the blue line. Good play to get it in the corner. It ricochets out to MacArthur. MacArthur to Cosbett. Checked there nicely by Matt Fox. And the puck will come over to Ian Munch. Munch at the center ice line, dumps it in, and he'll chase in after it. Nice play by the Wildcats to gain control. It's Nathan Cosbett with it.
Cadillac just put some fresh legs on the ice. Munch was kind of down there with no help, and he gets off for a breather.
5:48 to go here in the game, and this game is going by quickly, because there's not a lot of whistles. Alpena putting some pressure on, but coming out with it now is Mike Gussert. Gussert down the right side. Nice job by Cosbett. He's been on there a long time, too.
He just introduced himself to Cam Leotard.
Oh. Over top of the net by Mike Gussert.
Great chance for Mike Gussert on that. Just shot it high.
Alpena clears the zone and then takes a high hit from Ben Farley. Fans are getting their money's worth out of this one.
Yes, they are. Getting exciting. And, you know, there 5 minutes. There's a lot of time here. This game is far from over. 3-1.
Alpena's just going to dump it in and go for a change. Nick Meyer will stop it for David Carpenter. We are under 5 minutes to go. Good forecheck right there by Colby Plowman. Up the boards to Kasperiak. Kasperiak trying to get away from Kyle Van Dusen. There's a great back check by Van Dusen. He's everywhere. Is he a sophomore, Jeff, Kyle Van Dusen? Just curious.
Yes, he is.
Okay. That's yeah, as a sophomore, he is so active out there.
Yeah, he really is. He's been all over the place.
Somebody just got knocked
several
down.
Several times.
Alex Casper got knocked down. Letourneau at the blue line takes a hit from Eller.
It's going to be physical to the end.
And Nick Meyer will hold on to it. Coming in is Colby Plowman.
Ooh, that time has just been ticking off the clock here. We have not had a lot of whistles as we did in the second period.
Right.
And I'm sure Alpena's taking advantage of that as far as killing some time off here trying to protect their lead.
And as far as the timeouts go, do you think Coach Scott Graham will use his pretty soon?
It'd be my guess that he would. He's probably maybe the next time after he gets his top line out there, and then give them a little, maybe call a timeout, give them a little break. Probably going to be looking to pull the goalie at some point in time. I don't think he's going to wait until the last minute of play. Sometimes they pull him as soon as 2 minutes or even a little over 2 minutes, especially if you've got a two-goal deficit. So it'll be interesting to see what happens there.
That puck is kept in nicely by Hayden Watkins, and Alpena will come out to it at center ice. It's Aaron Nowak. He's being checked by Watkins. Nowak gets a weak shot off. In the corner now is Anthony Berg. Berg goes down. Brandon Eller with the check, and he's had some good hits tonight. Puck is along the boards. Digging after it is Eller. And coming out with it is Alex Leotard. Alex is knocked over there by Ben Budnick.
Considerable size difference
there. Oh, yeah. Yeah, big time. Cadillac will play it back. We've got 3 minutes to go here in the third period. The Alpena Wildcats are up 3-1. There's a huge hit on Matt Fox, and that just stung him. Wow.
Yeah, that was Shane Hamp. Put a big hit there.
Nick Esch now with some good speed as he goes around, cuts to the middle, holds on to it, and we got a goal.
That is
from
a goal. That is a goal. He did get around him and sneak it right in.
Nick Esch.
Wow.
That's a great individual effort right there.
Yeah, and that was all speed. Speed and hands there. Nice play. That kind of just deflated the Cadillac bench there. As I'm sure with 2:36 left in the game here, they were probably just getting ready to maybe take Nick Meyer off to gain that extra skater.
I don't know about you, but that really echoes in my ears loud. Coming out is Evan Letourneau. Letourneau goes around his man, tries to bring it out front. Right there is Colby Plowman for the Wildcats. Picking it up is Van Dusen back to the point. There's a shot by Cam Cosbett and just over the crossbar. Alpena is not letting up at all. Now Gussert checking his man. That's Colby Plowman working hard. Kyle Van Dusen, the sophomore, puts it into the corner. Plowman takes a hit from Cam Leotard. Alpena will keep it in on a good play there. And then bringing the puck out is Mike Gussert. Gussert down the left side. Van Dusen is just hounding him all the way in. Wrap around. Dakota Meyer makes the save. Ben Farley trying to get a shot, but Alpena's forcing him out wide.
Yeah, and Meyer made a nice play there, the goalie, to keep the puck from the crease and a chance for Cadillac.
We've got a minute 26 to go here. It's 4-1 Alpena with a commanding lead. There's a giveaway, pass over, shot, deflects over top of the net. Number 9 is Tom Hine. They haven't called his name too much for Alpena.
No. And boy, Cadillac defensively, as far as their defense goes anyway, they have blocked a number of shots tonight.
Deflected
a number of shots tonight. And yet Alpena has still got a lot of shots on goal tonight. So
yeah.
It tells you the kind of opportunities Alpena's had on the offensive end.
Alpena now with just a little over a minute to go here in the third. They have control. It'll go back to the blue line and then out. They're going to have to get back onside. Nick Meyer stopping it for Brian Geiger. There's two Wildcats right behind the net to get the puck. They've got Rosnowski open at the point. Rosnowski Here's a one-timer. That shot is wide by Berg. Cosbett knocks his man down. First one to it is Dacey, number 14. Brendan Dacey for the Wildcats. 30 seconds to go. MacArthur over to Camp Cosbett. He'll just dump it in the zone. Under 30 seconds to go here. There's a huge hit on Brian Geiger from MacArthur. Nick Ash goes right around his man. He's got some good speed and skills there. There's another goal by, but the referee,
I think Nick is maybe calling for interference in the crease.
Yeah.
And right away, too, he was calling for that.
Well, there was somebody definitely in his face. I thought it could have been an interference or at least a crease violation. But nevertheless, that'll do it. It's 5-1 with 11 seconds to go, and the Vikings are going to lose their conference opener. And Alpena with an impressive victory here tonight.
Yeah, they had a good all-around game. You know, outshot them, out-hustled them, outplayed them. Cadillac did manage to stay in the game for quite a while, but
Alpena
was just too much for them tonight.
Saved there by Dakota Meyer. 1 second to go. That'll do it. And Alpena with a very impressive road victory here tonight in Cadillac. It's 5-1.
Yeah, and Alpena is going to be a force, no doubt about it, in the conference.
Yes, we'll see. We'll see at the end of the season when Cadillac meets them again how Cadillac is can kind of come up with a game plan for them
when they make the long trip over to Alpena.
Yes. All right. Jeff and I will be back with the post-game show in just a moment. You are watching high school hockey action on 26 Sports and CCTV. Jeff and I will be right back in just a moment with the post-game show.